Hello everyone, today we are going to study about the duodenum. The duodenum is located opposite to the first, second and third lumbar vertebrae above the level of umbilicus. It's derived from the Latin word which means 12 finger breadth. It is 25 cm long and divided into four parts. The first part is about 2.5 cm long. This is the first part which extends from the pylorus to the superior duodenal fascia. The first part of the duodenum is extends from the pylorus to superior duodenal fascia. It's about 2.5 cm long. It's also called a superior part. The second one is the descending part. This descending part of the second part, it extends from the superior duodenal fascia to the inferior duodenal fascia. It's about 7.5 cm long. And then the third part, or the horizontal part, it's extending from the inferior duodenal fascia to the continuation of the fourth part. It's about 7.5 cm in length, and it runs straight and slightly upwards, crossing the aorta and the inferior vena cava. And then the fourth part, or also called as ascending part, it runs by the lateral to the aorta. It's about 2.5 cm long. And now the visceral relation of each part. The first part in proximal 2.5 cm is mobile, as it is in the upper part, it is attached to the lesser omentum, and the lower part is attached to the greater omentum. And the distal 2.5 cm is fixed, it's a retroperitoneal, and only anterior surface is attached to the peritoneum. And then the second part is completely retroperitoneal, which is completely fixed and not mobile. And then but it is also anteriorly covered by the peritoneum. And the visceral relation of third part, it is completely retroperitoneal structure as well as the second part, and it's only anterior side is covered by the peritoneum, and it's retroperitoneal, completely fixed, which cannot be mobile. And then the fourth part is mostly retroperitoneal, but except at its tip, where it is suspended by the uppermost part of the mesentery, where it forms the duodeno-jejunal fascia.